minimum matinee. I ain't got 750 to pay.
Leonardo DiCaprio in the house of creepy looking actors. You know, they got, because they got Max von Sydow in this, Jackie Earl Haley, Elias Koteas. I'm like, where's Forrest Whitaker at?
You know, well, hard to tell who the bad guy's gonna be.
Yeah, I know.
Wow, Ben Kingsley.
I know,
Ben I don't know. You know, it's Shutter Island. Anything can happen. We've got the world's largest storehouse of shutters. Come down to Shutter Island.
It's a Martin Scorsese movie, and I think Martin Scorsese is having sex with Leonardo DiCaprio or something, because he's just inspired him to keep using him in movies.
Hey, you find something good, you keep it going.
It is every kind of spook house cliche in a movie that looks like it was taking itself way too serious. I mean, you go off to this island in the middle of a storm. It's 1954, and Marshal Teddy Daniels, which is Leonardo DiCaprio's character, along with his buddy Chuck.
Ruffalo!
Yeah, which is Mark Ruffalo. So they go to creepy Shutter Island, where they have to investigate the baffling disappearance of a female patient from a supposedly inescapable hospital for the criminally insane. And the movie moves so slow that it was actually getting on my nerves at one point. I mean, because the movie is riddled with all these hallucinations that Leonardo DiCaprio's characters
have. Not
at having.
First. At first, it just seems like, okay, these guys are in a bad situation that they got to get out of. And it's moving pretty slow. And then when the hallucinations come in, it's a dream. So it's like, okay, well, that makes sense.
That is going to be the key for some people, is that whole, like, can you look back at everything you've seen this movie and buy their reasoning at the end that this could happen at all? And yeah, it is kind of far-fetched, but it's not so bad that you're going to go, f*** this entire film.
It's such a visually driven film that it reminds me of another movie that he did that I didn't like that much, Bringing Out the Dead.
I actually enjoyed all the visuals, and I enjoyed the ride I went on, because, I mean, I went into this knowing it was Scorsese, and Scorsese wasn't going to choose material that wasn't going to end up going somewhere. It just completely unfolds for you, and you see how everything had a brilliant double meaning.
I mean, I don't know. Maybe the thing that's, like, weirding me out about this movie is, like, there's a whole bunch of signs that say, do not come in this f***ing asylum.
I know.
But, like almost on purpose, they put their craziest inmates out in the yard just to scare people from coming in. I mean, like, the moment I saw that one bitch with her hair coming out, and her throat is slit, and she's still alive, she's talking about, shh, I'm like, I'm gone. At the beginning of that movie, went on the boat. Mark Ruffalo's, he's looking all stylish and cutting his clothes. Yeah. And Leonardo DiCaprio looks like a little boy wearing his daddy's clothes.
Yeah, he does. And then Mark Ruffalo goes, hey, boss, are you all right? You're like, he's your boss? That's got to be humiliating.
He should be saying, hey, kid, run to the store and give me a pack of smokes. Now, actually, I think that chick in the front yard with the slit throat and the hair loss is actually one of the chicks that Leonardo DiCaprio has been with. I think, how you think he stays so young? He just sucks the life force right out of him. Another soul, another day.
But it is a long movie. It's 2 hours and 18 minutes long.
Yeah, they still could have trimmed it just a little bit.
I agree. I mean, that was this part where I was kind of dozing off, where I'm like, okay, I'll wake up again when they move on to something new.
Yeah. Of course, when was the last time you saw a short Scorsese film?
No, that's a very good
point. I mean, let's say the one complaint people have is that Scorsese could be a little tighter in his edits.
As that sort of over-the-top creepy film, it actually is creepy as hell.
But to be locked up in this creepy-looking insane asylum, and if something went wrong and all these people got loose, that's terrifying to me.
Hell yeah.
Really, this movie, more than any movie I can remember in a long time, has given me a better sense of paranoia than this film. As Leonardo DiCaprio was losing his mind, I was like yelling, Scorsese, stop with my mind!
There's some things I go, well, why would they even do that? That doesn't make sense to me. That being said, it's still a high matinee film. I mean, you have to see this and make up your own mind.
You are rewarded for your patience if you just wait. I mean, it's so many things that are happening, and they all come together. And either you accept it or you don't, because really, some of it is kind of far-fetched.
I give it a low full price, if that's such a thing.
I'm full price, too. I absolutely love this film.
And look, I'm talking about Leonardo DiCaprio like I don't like him or something. I mean, that's not the case. I actually
envy him.
I envy him. I mean, if I was, like, around him, I would continuously punch him in the face, because
you wouldn't. You'd be part of his pussy posse.
Yeah,
he would be like your Frank Sinatra, where you would do anything he said just so you could hang out.
Leonardo DiCaprio is that one guy where he has so much money, so pretty. I mean, it helps that he looks like a girl. If he said, hey, you know what? Give me $1 million if you f*** me. I'd be like, okay, why not? You know, all right. It's Leonardo DiCaprio.
Can you shave first, at least? Do me that.
Can you put this wig on? Can you tuck, you know, at least while the lights are on, you know? We can make this happen.